With the A7S and the FS7, Sony has put the S-Log profile into a package that's affordable for actual mortal normal users. The problem is it's actually extremely difficult to color grade. But I found a workflow that works quickly and effectively that I'd like to share with you guys today. First off, shout out to Espionage Films that did a basic video going over their workflow. They didn't really do a tutorial of it, but theirs is really the foundation of what mine is based on. So first off, we'll be using DaVinci Resolve Lite, which is amazingly a free program, which is really crazy when you think about how powerful it is. First thing I'm gonna do is create a new node. If you're not familiar with nodes, think of them as kind of a super advanced layer in Photoshop. And under the color wheels, I'm gonna go to the offset and bring this down. Now the reason I'm bringing it down is that I have found S-Log loves light. So in general, I shoot probably anywhere from 1.5 to 2 stops over and just make sure I'm not clipping out the whites on the raw footage. So that's why the footage you're seeing looks so bright. So once I have the exposure and kind of a general idea of where I want it, I'm going to add a second node. This is a pretty standard DaVinci workflow in that you make your primary adjustments in your first node and then do the more traditional kind of grading in a second or third node or however many you need to get to. So in my second node, I'm going to apply a LUT, a lookup table. Think of those as color presets. The ones I'm using are from Vision Color. Now these are paid, but they're super professional. I really love them, so I think it's worth it. The one I'm going to use in particular is the codec 5213. It's made to emulate the look of that particular film stock. And you see the second I apply it, it makes a massive difference in the footage. I think the LUT is looking a little too strong for me. So in the keying tab here in the center, I'm gonna just bring the gain down a little to make it a little less strong and a little more natural looking. And my final adjustment back on the first node is going to be to the highlights and shadows. Now this is probably not the most professional method for doing this, but I think it's the most effective actually. And that is under the color match, just adjusting these highlight and shadow sliders. They work just as they would in a still image editing program like Lightroom. And I absolutely love them for kind of balancing out the contrast and giving me an image where I'm not clipping whites or losing data in the low end. So with just this simple 3-step process, I'm able to take advantage of everything that S-Log has to offer and still not spend a ton of time in my post workflow. And in Resolve, it's easy just to take a grab of that particular shot and then apply it to similar shots so I'm not having to repeat these same movements over and over and can just do minor tweaks to get the same results. So that's it guys, my S-Log workflow here in Resolve. As always, if you got any questions, you can hit me up on Twitter. Check out some of my other videos if you liked this one. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys next time.